Hey yo, we're back. Roll intro.
Now, who's hot, who not? Tell me who rock, who sell out in the stores. You tell me who flop, who cop the blue drop, who jewels got box, who mostly Gucci down to the blue drop. The same old pimp, Mace, you know ain't nothing changed but my limp. Can't stop till I see my name on a blimp. Guarantee me and shells call a level up. You don't believe in Harlem World, nigga, double up. We don't play around, it's a bet, lay it down. Niggas didn't know me, 91, bet they know.
Okay, so before we get into this reaction, massive shout out goes to and yes, you are the MVP. Hey yo, check it. So before we get into this Pearl Jam a live reaction, live MTV Unplugged, please remember to match the energy of that subscribe button, run up the likes on that like button, and also please hit that post notification bell so you can be down every time I drop a video. But everybody who's been following this channel, you already know how I feel about Pearl Jam from the first like two reactions I did of theirs. My favorite song that they did was Jeremy. So we're gonna get into a live and see how I feel about this. So without further ado, let's skip all the semantics and pleasantries and see what they have to say. You can already tell you're gonna get great emotion from this. Song. Woo! Come on.
Here, I got a little story for you. What you thought was your daddy was nothing but a while you were sitting.
Oh, this is deep.
But I'm glad we talk. Oh, I'm still alive. I'm still alive. I'm still alive.
Come on, vocals. I love the rasp in his voice.
Oh, she walks slowly across a young man's room. She said, "Hey, you." Oh, I can't remember anything of this fairy deal except the love.
I love how he's singing a story. Like, I guess this is, I don't know if this is dedicated to his mom or what, but I know from the first part of the song where he was sitting there saying that his mom says something about, I guess he was at home while his real dad was dying. So I'm wondering if he was at home with maybe like somebody who was like a father figure in his life. Maybe, I don't know. I'm not 100% sure. And she was at the hospital with his real dad, or was she telling him the story of his somebody who he thought was, who he thought wasn't really his real dad, was actually his real dad, was laying in the hospital dying while she had someone that was around him that was perpetrating and portraying his father, but actually wasn't, if that makes sense. So I don't know. This is kind of deep, but whatever it is, I'm here for it. I can't say that. I love it. Let's get back into this.
I'm still alive.
Come on. And you could sense the frustration from him, because I feel like it still haunts and hurts him, maybe. Because you could sense the pain from looking at him. Like, he's really feeling these lyrics. Woo! I love their live music. Their live music is so amazing. Like, there's such a like connection and rawness that they possess. I like that. That was nice. That was dope. I like that. They killed it. Okay, so let's quickly talk about Pearl Jam with the live. I definitely love this song. And the thing that I love about this song is the connection that everybody made with this song. Even though I'm pretty sure that this was based off of the life of the lead singer, if I'm not mistaken. But just to see that everybody that's a part of this group has some type of connection and was drawn from some sort of inspiration, maybe some type of trauma they have may have experienced, and they were able to channel that and put that in within their execution of the track and command that stage. It was absolutely phenomenal. The stage presence, everything. And then, like I said, with the lead singer, like I said, from listening to the story, I really get a feeling that he was speaking about the relationship with his mother. And this is crazy, because this is a story to me of like forgiveness, of perseverance, of like triumph, tragedy, and just wanting to sit there and basically him saying, even though I've been through all these things, I'm still alive. But to get back into the story, like, I really felt like this story was about his mother telling him a story of somebody not being his father, and he actually was at home with this person that really wasn't his father, while his biological father was in the hospital and was dying, and he wasn't able to be present with the man whom he is half of, basically, if that makes sense. So in a way, it's like he never got to say his final goodbye to his actual biological father, which is crazy, because it's like like you can really sense that like that really affected him because of the connection and the deepness and the rawness and the emotion that he was able to evoke. Like you could sense it like in his face and just in the way his voice was cracking. Like you could tell that that really affected him, and that, and it seemed like it was still kind of affecting him, or you could still tell that it's a part of him. And I love the connection and the rawness that he portrayed, and just the transparency and the courage that it took for him to tell that story. And I loved it because I was able to relate it to myself and the tragedies that I had to go through. Not in a way, like I didn't know my father until like I was around like 24 or so, my biological father. Because anybody who's watched this channel, you already know and listen to my personal story that I grew up in foster care. But it reminds me of like almost the same thing of what like my aunt who placed me into foster care, really after my great grandmother passed away and after I got taken away by the police from my biological mother. Who used to sit there and always try to sit there and just get in my head and make me feel so bad about who my dad was, and just made all these lies of manipulation of trying to tear me down as a child because her kids weren't doing what they were supposed to do, and just telling me who my father was and who it wasn't, and sitting here telling me that some older man that was like my great-grandmother's friend was my dad and my mom was with him when she was 15, and like just these lies that you would sit there and try to tell a kid to just break their spirit. And it made me always go through life trying to question, is this really my dad, is this really my dad, or the person that they said is my great-grandmother, or is who my mother said was my dad. And like I always feel like God never makes mistakes, so he kind of came full circle. Because when I moved to Buffalo, I actually moved with my foster dad, who actually grew up with my biological father, and they grew up together in the same neighborhood, and that's how I wound up meeting my biological father, because of my foster dad, because they grew up together and they knew each other. And I feel like God never makes mistakes, and that he put me in that situation for a reason, to sit there and know him, because I know that God would not sit there and lead me to meet some man that wasn't my actual dad face to face, if you get what I'm saying. So all that to say is like I can really feel his pain in a sense. Not in the same exact way, but we all have tragedies and stories that we come from and stem from, that we can actually build and learn from each other. And I just thought that they all did a phenomenal job, and with the connection with this track, I thought it was absolutely amazing, absolutely phenomenal. I loved it. Pearl Jam is definitely an amazing group, and I have nothing negative to say. Like, I love this song. So with that being said, please let me know what you thought of Pearl Jam with Alive in the comments below. And please be safe out there. Remember to stay awesome. Be awesome, because you guys are all awesome. This is your boy Mark, and I'm signing off. Deuces. Peace.